be stinking spring.
I'm doing this in the nakedness. Usually I'm in my skivvies.
Like a boat. I'm
watching. What do you think?
I'm loving it. It's bringing stuff back to me. When I was about 10 years old, Jerry, my dad and my twin brother and I built a 6-foot rowboat, and we used marine plywood with fiberglass over it. It was heavy, but that thing held up for years. I had many, many happy hours rowing
this
that.
This one is not heavy. Look at this.
Oh my gosh. No, it's something? Not. Yeah, that's amazing.
Look at that. Even a weak guy like me can lift it, but that's why I'm doing this, to make it lightweight so I can put a 40 horse motor on the thing. So
cool.
It'll be it's going to be very unusual. It's different inside also.
It's very wide and stable.
Yeah, and it's got a flat bottom.
Right, flat bottom.
Small engine. So you know, everybody's used to running 150 horse engines on their boats around here and 175 horse engines and stuff.
It ain't about speed, is it?
Well, it ain't about, you know what it's about?
What?
Economy.
Yes, well, that too.
Environment and economy, you know what I mean? And also to try and run a, to try and feed a 150 horse motor is not the easiest thing in the world.
Right.
So I built this light with a flat bottom.
Well, yeah.
With a V-hull.
Yeah, well, 150 horse motor's going to weigh how much, Jerry?
Yeah,
a lot.
I'll bet,
more than the dang boat probably does.
Yeah, probably 300 pounds or something.
Yeah.
250 maybe, I would guess, in that area.
Going to be stern heavy, big time.
Yeah, so on this goes a 40 horse because with the flat bottom, I don't have to lift it out of the water, the big V. I don't have
right.
to lift it out of the water, so it should get right up.
Right, right. It's going to be fun.
Plane. It'll do about, probably 22, 23 knots. And that's plenty.
Yeah, you don't need
to
go fast. You don't want to go fast on those skinny little creeks because you don't know what's coming around the corner.
You can't see things go by.
Yeah, that too. Uh-oh, I was leaning on something.
Oh, that's all right.
I know, but it's about to come over.
That's okay. It'll lean against the boat. Push.
Okay.
Yeah, just go ahead and let it push.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it'll just lean.
All right, I thought that was me. I thought,
So what brings you this way?
Well, you know, Mike, Kane at Mike's working. I left him working on the sign for the base camp. He's got a really cool sign going up made out of a shrimp door, otter trawl door on a shrimp boat.
Cool.
So he's polyurethaning that. And I thought I would bring the dog down and do a walk on the river ramble. I like to patrol that. I try to get out there every day.
Right.
But,
right.
So that's what I'm doing. Plus, I thought you might be working on this, being that it's so nice.
Yeah, and I was going to have it'll have a keel, a little longer keel, about maybe, this is 3 feet, but maybe 6 feet
okay.
or 5 feet down about like that, just to help it track a little bit better.
Right.
So.
Yeah, because it is long.
It is long, and
you
it's
could
light.
Put some of those, what do they call those strakes? You know, on the bottom.
You mean the runners, the strikes are going? Yeah,
yeah,
I could, but I think I'll be all right. If I have to add them later, I'll go ahead and add them later. But
right.
I think we're going to be all right on the darn thing, you know?
Yeah, exciting. So I hate to ask this because I've been asked this a gazillion times, but when do you think she'll be ready to for christening?
I'm hoping by, when's the boat show?
April sometime, so you got at least a month.
Yeah. So I may not be totally finished, but it's going to be in the water by the end of March.
I'm excited, Jerry.
And then we'll talk about those other things.
Yeah, what are your plans here?
Store,
what are your plans for, do you have a name picked out, or is that super secret right now?
No name yet, but The tiny tannic.
I love that.
The tiny
tannic. We've got a little 12-foot aluminum. I think I told you this, with a little 15 horse on it.
Yeah.
We call it the creek sneaker.
Creek sneaker?
Yeah, the creek sneaker.
Well, everybody says, well, it ain't going to float, Jerry. You're going to be lucky if it floats. And I said, well, that's why I might name it the tiny tannic then.
Are you kidding? It's going to float? Who's skeptical?
Oh, they're just harassing
me. Okay,
you know,
I was going to say.
You know?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But anyway, so
cool.
So much for this little rig.
Yeah, so what are your plans? Do you want to give them out, or do you want to keep them to yourself? Close?
Well,
I can always edit it out if you change your mind.
This right now, I'm building it for, that's the horn. The horn over there.
Yeah, really?
That's the horn.
We're going to have some salty dogs on here, I hope?
Yeah, salty dogs. Oh, that's why, one of the reasons I'm building this.
For the dogs.
Because I have 5 dogs, as you know.
Yeah, that gets a little crowded.
5 dogs and a wife.
Uh-huh.
So I had to build her a separate little cabin so she can ride up there and won't bother us.
Oh, yeah.
And then the 5 dogs and I can have some fun, you see. So that's what we're gonna do. No, really, but I do have 5 dogs and I have the houseboat, as you know.
Mm-hmm.
So this is going to be the water taxi.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. So
that was the initial.
Lots of groceries.
Yeah. Well, and also, when we get to where we're going, it's a buck a mile. I mean, a gallon of fuel per mile to run the other boat.
Yeah, so it's much easier to do exploration. The other thing's going to be your base camp on the water.
Yeah, that'll be the
your
base
water
camp,
camp your water base camp. And this will be the taxi. Sounds like a great idea.
And then there may be some commercial entities involved.
Yeah, well, so I want to know, we could put a couple of 8-foot kayaks in here, too.
Yeah,
it's wide enough, huh?
Yeah.
I wouldn't think
I wish
about
it was,
that.
Well, you can look under it if you want, and you'll see there's tons of deck.
This I am going to crawl on the ground and take
unusual.
A picture from
it's
the underside.
It's a full-length deck on this thing.
Yeah.
Different than anything around here, I think, that you'll ever see.
Okay, well, so, I can't wait.
The reason for that, there's a couple reasons. One is I have them in compartments. Mick!
He's barking at my dog.
Come here.
He's protecting you from my dog.
Wow. But I have compartments, and you'll see them. Like,
uh-huh.
And there's a 16-inch floor.
Okay, so are they airtight? Are you building airtight?
Not airtight, but watertight on this one.
That's what I meant, watertight.
And
I said airtight.
Center console area here.
Uh-huh.
And,
Oh, okay. It's going to be center? Are you... What's
your... Staring up in here.
Okay.
And then there's another... we'll call a hold, for lack of anything else, right up in here.
Wait a minute. Yeah, a little hold. Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then a full
for storage? I mean,
forward.
Where's your storage?
Well,
or is it all on deck?
It's all underneath. There's storage all
underneath. Okay.
Because there's decks that
so
run
it'll be
all
accessible.
The way down the side.
But the only watertight ones are going to be back there, right?
Right. And that's
okay,
so
I got
when
it.
I go somewhere I can put stuff in it. You know, groceries or whatever.
Right.
It's raining. Or with the hatch shut.
Mm-hmm.
You remember the old crisscrafts? They had the back end, and there were a deck.
Yes,
the
I do. I
the
do.
Guy
I do.
Up here.
That's
and there
right.
Were fancy boats.
Uh-huh.
And they had that deck.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Well,
for years, that was the style.
That's right. This is not exactly like that, but a similar concept. So I can do that hatch, and
uh-huh.
we can put a couple chairs and sit back there and fish or whatever, you know, or watertight it.
It's how much fun so this is. So I'm going to come back in a couple of days, I hope, or next stage you'll let me know, and we can follow the progress of the, maybe the tiny tannic.
The tiny tannic,
subject to revision, we're going to call her, right, the tiny tannic.
Tiny tannic. I'm just thinking, I came up with that name a few days ago because everybody's
I like
asking
it.
About it.
I like
months.
It.
The tiny tannic,
yeah. Yeah, yeah, I really like that.
Everybody will get the humor, I'm sure.
Oh, sure.
Tiny tannic. So.
Sure. And you can always, you know.
Change it and do whatever.
Yeah, whatever. Fun. I'm gonna go and shoot underneath it.
Okay. Let me... See this right here?
Don't let it fall on me. That would be super bad. As I film my demise. Pardon me?
See, I'll give you... Well, in fact, let's see. Let me look right here. Maybe... Oh, yeah. From right here...
Uh-huh.
Lean down and you'll see from right here. You see all the deck?
Oh, my gosh. That that's not.
Shut up.
Hey, baby.
Get out of here.
You're protecting Daddy. Yeah. That's okay. So that's kind of like taking a page from the oyster boat.
Well, sure, but theirs is up here.
Yeah,
and
right.
Put it down
and
so
you've lowered it, so there's some freeboard.
Freeboard and
yeah.
seating right
gotcha.
There. See?
Gotcha. Cool. I can't wait.
And then,
you got any sketches of this? Or is it all in your head?
Well, I built a couple 15-footers, and I modified the 15 and made this almost a 19.
Okay, this is, I was going to ask how long it is.
I have some sketches and all. And then if you look over
it is long. How wide is it at its widest part?
6'5" and 18 and a half. Or 19, maybe 19.
Uh-huh.
And if you look at this right here, what I'm going to do is so your knees get in this. See this?
That's okay.
And then
I got my overalls on.
And you see that hatch right there?
Oh, okay.
That's the one that'll be watertight.
Okay, for the groceries and stuff.
Yeah, and you see the seating?
Everything after that is where the motor and the gas can goes.
And there'll be a double floor.
And this is the sitting, yeah.
Because there'll be a floor 2 inches off the bottom.
Uh-huh.
And the console
there's a lot
goes,
of room.
Yeah, and the console goes
there's
here.
There's like 2 feet, right?
Yep. Console goes here.
Uh-huh.
And, well, right here from this side
right.
to here. That's where you steer. So you're almost
yeah.
in the middle.
Uh-huh.
But you have room to walk through because this I'm cutting out.
Oh, okay.
See, so you
yeah,
can
yeah,
walk
yeah.
from here
up
to the
forward.
Next one up forward.
Yeah, okay.
See? And then you
that'd
sit
cool.
here.
Uh-huh.
And there'll be a little seat and all that. And then up here, wow, I got this table in here right now.
Oh, yeah.
But look at the, see the deck all up in here?
Oh, yeah.
See how much, see the deck?
All of this forward, and then that's yeah. going to be a little storage hatch
and
right there.
A little storage area, yeah.
Oh, yeah, this is a big
see? And you can walk
deck.
All the way
you
through.
You can lie in this deck. It's almost, you
yeah,
know.
Yeah,
that's
well,
cool.
Well, that's why I say it's real unusual, the way I'm building the thing.
I think it's great.
Because I want to hold people and persons and dogs
and gear.
Food and gear and all that
neat.
Stuff.
Neat. So. Sounds great.
A pain trying to do this thing.
So, Jerry, you want to tell the half shell a little bit about your experience as a captain? Just briefly. I know you're modest.
Well, I'm almost naked.
I'm just doing shoulders up because I don't want the ladies.
Oh, good.
The
don't,
lady watchers.
To,
yeah, really.
Yeah, well, it's not a big story. My dad was a dredge captain, and I was born and raised down in Sarasota, Florida, and that's how I got on the water.
And at what got, age were you when you got on the water?
Oh. 15, 14, 13, maybe no less than that, I'm sure.
Started making your living right away on the water?
Well, my dad made his living there, so I helped
uh-huh.
him.
Oh, I see.
And then I got tired of water, so I joined the Air Force. That's something, right? And I realized that I still had to like, I liked the water more than anything else, so back into the water I went and ended up for a while as a captain in the oil business and sailed my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
So this powerboat thing is a newer thing to me, small powerboat thing.
Right.
But here I am, and I've chartered here the Governor Stone, which you may or may not.
Oh yeah,
know,
I remember
right?
very well.
In fact, that's why I'm here. They asked me to come here and run the schooner.
Mm-hmm.
The old schooner. And I like it well enough that I stayed.
And that was how many years ago?
22 or 3, thereabout.
So you need know these waters about as well as anybody that was growing
well,
up here.
I probably is the fishermen are the only ones that probably know it better
right.
in this area.
That's right.
And I say better only because they're very, very aware of the depths.
Right.
And fishing areas.
Yeah, that's the difference between
yeah.
sailing, going to port,
right.
and to power boating
yeah. right.
is you have to consider the depths the, very keenly aware.
Yep.
And so this is a flat bottom boat. So
and
you're
this
gonna,
one will do
this
more than the others. And
yeah.
we might have some people on this thing for y'all.
Yeah.
The Tiny Tannic may take some
yeah.
folks out on this
so
boat. You never know.
Do we? Are we all putting wagers on how much she'll draw? It depends on who's on board, I guess.
Well,
if all five dogs.
I can tell you this: an 1,100-pound load
uh-huh.
will float her right here.
Oh my gosh!
1,100 pounds, roughly, will float right there. according to the calculation.
That's going to be amazing.
So 6 inches of water plus an engine, because there's no...
So you're really building it for skinny water.
Skinny water, yeah.
Yeah, I'm with you there. Yeah.
But anyway, so that's...
Lots of unexplored skinny water,
yep.
As far as I'm concerned.
Yep. So that's kind of my story, and I'm sticking to it.
Okay, well,
and,
the story continues.
I don't plan on leaving, and hopefully we'll see some of...
All right, we're going to follow this. Yeah,
great.
I wish I could have caught it a little bit sooner, but that's okay. I have seen the progress. I just haven't videotaped it. But
Clarice was amazed because all the frames I built on the back porch in about... around December, I guess.
Right, I remember.
And I had them all stacked and, you know, lined up just together.
Right.
And when I finally brought it out here and set it up, she was amazed. She goes, I never thought it was going to be...
this big.
This big. By what I saw on the porch back there, by what she saw on the porch.
And it's really come together fast, I think. I've been amazed.
Well, it's stages. I mean... Yeah. It takes forever to get to this stage. And then it's going to seem to take forever to get this thing, the paint on and that sort of thing.
Right.
But, and then you flip it over. You think you're done. And you flip it over and you got the whole inside to do.
That's right.
So,
I remember about 3 months ago, saying, I think we're about halfway there.
Yeah. No, maybe
and you it's hard to tell how much time you have left in it, because every boat's different. It depends on the weather. We've had some hard winter weather where you can't fiberglass and whatnot. But
now
it's amazing.
I got
amazing.
The glass on it, so that's good. And I'm going to prime it and paint the bottom. And then worry about the rest, flip it, and do the rest of it when it's upright.
Right.
So that'll be the next stage. So I'm
great.
Just trying to get this thing primed and the bottom paint on it, and then I can be done with this. But I've got to put the trow on here, which will be a bunch of laminated lumber.
Right.
Coming up through here. It's going to be quite a bit of work, but that's the next thing. I'm going to glass it today, and then I'll put that trow on there.
Great. Well, I'm going to put this up on the web. And there's a couple of boat forums that I actually already have some half shell videos on.
Yeah, this is an old Bolger design.
Okay.
So, anybody out there that knows boating or building will probably know Bolger's boats.
Right. Okay, so, great. We're going to follow it if you'll let us.
This is kind of one of his designs, but I've modified it somewhat. But I liked his initial design, so I started with that and. And I'm doing some other things.
Reading. We've read it before, but Mike and I are in the throes of, we read stuff together, books together, and we're in the throes of reading The Commodore's Story again, which is about a fellow that settled in Key Biscayne in the late 1800s.
Yeah.
Ralph Monroe, that was his name. Came from Rhode Island area, and he was a boat designer, and of course had to radically designed different boats
for down here. Yes.
So very interesting how those traditional designs have been adapted.
One thing, and then and on this, as I progress with it, I make changes on it. You know, you have it in your head, and then you go, "Well, it might work a little better this way or that way or the other way, or why don't I do this or that?"
Exciting, isn't it? It's like giving birth.
It is.
It's like, that's why I'm excited hearing about it, going, where's the baby do? What's the baby do?
It's like giving birth. Right.
What's it going to look like?
Let me tell you,
it's going to look like you or Clarice.
And it's probably just as painful as birth, too.
Very exciting. Very exciting. All right. Well, we will follow your exploits.
All right. Well, we'll see you in the next edition of this tiny
Thanks for taking a break and talking to us today.